Hello everyone, Cherries Red Army, match day 9, match day vlog, AFC Bournemouth versus Luton. Can the Cherries remain unbeaten? Can the Cherries knock Luton off of their 4 consecutive draws? Cloudy conditions with a slight drizzle means AFC Bournemouth players can put all the effort into this, knowing that we have a talented bench if need be. Make sure you subscribe to the channel, smash the like as well. Hope you enjoy the video. Going for a 3-1 Cherries win.
In the sky. Kite didn't fly very high, to be fair. Fair play to him though. We all have pre-match rituals. Flying a kite gets him ready for the game. Each to their own. You're so golden. Lineups are out then, unchanged from Scott Parker. Pearson keeps his place. Brooksy does not get a start. Got Aaron Kay, found him. He's making his way round to the north stand. How you doing, Aaron?
Very good, thank you. Yes, good cut.
Unchanged then, what's your thoughts?
I mean, I'm not surprised. It was obviously a great performance at Cardiff, but like a lot of people, I thought Brooksy would come back in today for Ben Pearson. Nothing against Ben Pearson, but I thought we needed him away from home. Maybe not so much today, but he performed brilliantly. So, you know, fair enough, keep an unchanged team.
And Luton threw away a 3-0 lead last week, drew 3-3. We expect him from the start of this game.
Well, they can score goals, but they can concede them. So I think it'll be quite a ding-dong game. I'd like to think they'd come and play. I know they've got lots of injuries, but hopefully they'll come and play and give us a chance to open them up.
Score prediction?
I'm going to go for 2-0 to Bournemouth.
Enjoy the game in the North Stand. So we've got some junior Cherries walking around to the North Stand as well. What's your name?
Joshua.
And what's your name? Zach. What do you think of today's game, Joshua?
I thought maybe Brooks could have come in for Pearson, but I think it's a strong lineup and we have a really good chance.
And what's your score prediction?
I'm going to go for 2-0 Bournemouth.
I also would like to see Brooks start, maybe instead of Ben Pearson, or Mark Kunders get a game for a while. Maybe see Jamal Lowe start, but I also think it'll be 2-1 Bournemouth.
2-1 Bournemouth. Solanke scored today, he's on 5 already.
Well, I think I saw 2.
2 for Solanke. Yeah. Up the Cherries.
Yeah. get used to slow starts this season in certain games, and it's been another slow one this season. Oh, nearly a mistake by Travis. Adebayo's already missed a sitter, an open goal. And Travis nearly let him in for another open goal. Two let-offs. We need to wake up. 15 minutes gone. 0-0.
Aaron, how were we not 2-0 down after 20 minutes?
Same as usual, isn't it? Same story. We start slowly in every game. And how Adebayo didn't score, I think it hit the ball onto his foot, went over, and then Travs almost gave it straight to him. Yeah, they were the better team for the first 15, 20 minutes. And then, you know, we seemed to be clinical at the other end. Brilliant ball from Christie, who's been that superb. Great volley from Phil Bill. And hopefully that record continues. And then again, a great corner routine, hopefully straight from the training ground. And it's 2-0, and even after that, they were looking dangerous going forward. I can see how they can see goals, but I can see how they score them as well. So the next goal's massive, but yeah, I mean, I don't think we necessarily deserve it. I don't think we deserve it at all, but we're 2-0 up and we'll take it.
Just like in previous games, that first real attack, first real chance, put it in the back of the net, settled us down, Billing scored. That normally means we get a result. But the second half, just like in QPR, we've got to make sure that we keep organised and don't let them back in the game.
Yeah, I mean, look, we all think back to Blackpool. Hopefully that's in their minds and we'll learn from that. Hopefully what happens against Barnsley, we get a third one and then go on to win the game comfortably. The next goal's been massive. Obviously QPR got that and we managed to hold on. But Luton do look a handful going forward, so I think we've got to be careful. But hopefully we can marshal it at the back. Kayla and Kelly have been superb again. And yeah, I think hopefully we'll be comfortable.
A slow start to this half as well. Travis just made a great one-handed save from a free kick set piece from Luton, headed, and a great one-handed save by Travers. But again, another slow start, 50 minutes on the clock, and we need to get going again, still 2-0.
No one in the box.
Oh, what a game.
Luton just scored. It's now 2-1, 63 on the clock. Keep your all over again. Hopefully not Blackpool, but we need to get a third goal in this game. Remember, we did go for the famous 3-1, so that is still on. We need to get control of this game again.
Sessions for the Cherries, show the appreciation for the number 10, Ryan Christie.
Like versus QPR, Chris Meppen comes on now. Game balanced at 2-1. We now got three centre backs again. 15 or so minutes to go, or maybe less. It's going to be nervy. Top of the league again. And breathe. Don't even know where to start, but let's start at the start. Again, another match for the first 10-15 minutes where we struggle to get a hold of the game. Really, really poor on the ball, and Luton had the better chances, and arguably Luton could have taken the lead. Adebayo had an open goal, should we say, got his feet all tangled up, missed that chance. Then Travers tried to hand one on a plate to him as well, but we got away with that. But just like in previous matches, the first real attack and first real clear-cut chance we had, we took it through Phil Billing. And that settled us down, and that settled me down, because when Billing scores, pretty much tells me there's a good high chance we're going to get a result. Then we got on the ball, Jordan Zamora, a player that's playing so well this season, but he does, when he gets the ball, take us 30, 40 yards up the pitch. His initial instinct is to drive into space quickly with the ball, and our threat was coming down the left-hand side. The second goal, though, to give us a bit of breathing space in the first half, would come through Dom Solanke, a header, his sixth goal of the season. Didn't have a perfect performance today, Dom Solanke, especially when we come on to it in the second half, where he needed to hold the ball up and give us a break. But he got the sixth goal of the season in the league for him, and we went in 2-0 up. But Luton made a change, probably a formation one as well. Substitute came on, and again in the second half we started poorly. We were on the ropes a little bit, just like hopefully Usyk will be versus Joshua. But Luton would get the third goal in the game. Just like previously at home against QPR, the game then went 2-1. And we knew again it might be a 25, 30 minute struggle. You know, nerves would kick in. But we'd be looking for maybe one good counter-attack to give us that breathing space. Substitutes would come on. Morgan Rogers came on like for Jaden Anthony. Christie came off and Chris Meppham come on, a third centre-back, just like in against QPR. And that generally means that we're going to drop deeper. We will invite pressure, but hopefully we've got the experience and we've got the sort. Scott Parker had the resolve to sort of get that back line organised so we could defend any balls in the box, set pieces, direct balls, etc. Jamal Lowe came on for Solanke really, really late, but we didn't really get that final chance that we wanted to see the game out. And Ben Pearson was voted man of the match in the stadium over the Tannoy. But in the 90th minute, there was three giant heading clearances from Gary Cahill. Even one wasn't even for him, and he just went straight past our own player and the Luton player and cleared one for a throw-in. And his experience and leadership is giving us so much confidence at the back that if we do concede a goal, we don't hopefully concede more, because probably we would have let this game go last season. But we got the 3 points. Final whistle went. Scott Parker and the boys, a fourth consecutive win. Another 2 goals scored at home. And we go on top of the league. And we now lead our way away from home in midweek. We go to Peterborough. We'll let you know what's coming up for that, actually. We'll try and get you a preview on Monday or Tuesday, likely to be Tuesday. And we will be looking to go for a watch-along, a second watch-along on the channel with myself and John Spark for Peterborough. So check that out. Hit the notifications on the channel so you don't miss a single video, and also you won't miss any news coming up on that watch-along. But it was AFC Bournemouth 2. Luton 1, another 3 points, top of the league. We want to know what you think if you're at the game or if you're watching this match day vlog, you were listening on the radio. What's your thoughts? How are you feeling in those final moments? Let us know in the comments. Subscribe if you're new to the channel. We're so close to 650 subscribers, so please subscribe and smash the like. AFC Bournemouth 2, Luton 1, top of the league. The Cherries march on. Until the next video, we'll see you soon. Up Cherries.